roads in Yellowknife remain unplowed. That concludes our holiday weather report. But in the holiday spirit, we now present to you the Egg Christmas Special.
Good day, it's Egg. Looks like we have another Christmas Eve on our hands. You know, I haven't had much to offer in the way of Gundam reviews lately, but it just wouldn't feel like Christmas if we didn't sit back and do some random nonsense together. I hope you guys got your hot chocolate on standby and some half-baked baking ready to go, because we got some gifts to open. No need to wait for Christmas morning, guys. I'm pulling the Finn card on this one. Is anyone gonna understand that joke? Okay, yeah, maybe someone. First up, we have something from Cousin Dickory, and he did a great job rapping as usual. Let's see what he has to say.
Hello, Ick! I found the darn tootin' swelling game in the bargain shop at the Lobo gas station and figured you could play it on your channel. Someone told me people make money doing that stuff. You know, playing games and talking and stuff. I think you'll do great. Regards, Cousin Dickory.
Well, someone's 14 years in the past, but huh, would you look at this?
For the first gift of Egg, Cousin Dickory gave to me a Sega Saturn game.
Mobile Suit Gundam for the Sega Saturn. I just got that system on eBay this year. I really don't know why, but the supersonic racing, right? Since Cousin Dickory is stuck in the past, I sure hope you won't mind if I record my TV screen with my camera, because what's a man to do? Go buy a capture card on Christmas Eve? This game is sorta interesting. It's a side-scrolling shoot-em-up that uses the 3D space to create a battlefield on three different planes. Pressing B fires at the enemies directly in front of you, while the A button shoots at enemies in the background. This leads to some pretty cluttered screens full of action from all sides. At the start of the mission, you can choose which allies to place throughout the map, and you'll see them duking it out alongside you. Like most classic games, it'll only take you about 10 to 20 minutes until you figure out what's going on with the controls. There was this moment where it took me forever to get this one little guy. He just kept flying in different directions. I didn't know what to do. It's not very hard at first until you hit stage 4, where things rapidly get more sweaty. This is actually a decently fun game, and the animated cutscenes are amazing. I mean, wow, imagine if the original Gundam series actually looked like this. Throughout the game, there are lots of unskippable dialogue moments, followed by brief battles, making it a perfect representation of the original anime. You don't need to know Japanese to figure out what's going on here, so long as you know the story of Gundam, that is. I can see myself playing this some more and enjoying it as soon as I figure out what to do fully. Alright, I'm hungry. Time to eat some festive trash. Remember when these actually came in rolls that you cut up and everything? Well, they don't do that anymore, so I don't know, we'll just put this in the oven here and take a look at the next gift from, Uncle Larry. Oh boy, I'm sure this is gonna be good.
My dearest Egg, your Uncle Larry almost didn't make it to the holiday season this year. But thankfully, my open yolk surgery was a success. And the first thing I did after leaving them hospital doors was go straight to the local hobby shop and get you a Gundam model to review on your channel. My eyesight ain't quite 20/20 these days. Some may say it's more like 20/22. That's a little rip that I'm just giving you there. Okay, you can stop laughing now. But anyway, I hope you will appreciate this gift. Signed, with love, Uncle Larry.
I can't believe he made it. Last year, Uncle Larry sent me not an actual Gundam model, so let's see if he got it right there. No, he didn't.
It was the second gift of Egg, and Uncle Larry gave to me a Lego Lamborghini.
Lego Speed Champions Lamborghini Countach. What the hell? I haven't built brick Lego in a long time, and I never really even cared about this stuff when I was a kid, but hey. This is an affordable set of a classic supercar with 262 pieces, retailing for about $30 Canadian. Inside the box, we got two bags, a manual, and a sheet of stickers. The build is very fun and far more advanced than the Lego of the early 2000s. Everything is so streamlined and satisfying. I'd be putting things together, having no idea where it was going, only to be amazed when it all formed this wonderful car. The Countach's design actually lends itself very well to Lego, so that's cool. I love the way the headlights are made with stickers on the bottom and a clear piece on the top. I also like all the moving parts that slide into place to make the curves of the car. There's even a well-made interior with a shifter and steering wheel. A lot of love and care was put into this set, and it shows. You get a driver minifigure with the car as well, and he comes with his fancy little Lamborghini jacket and a wrench. He goes hard, he goes fast, and he never looks back. I can't get over how nice this set looks. Like, this is just Lego, man. To me, it's always something like I see the sets and I think, well, I'd like to build that, but I don't actually want to keep it. But this Countach is a seriously nice looking set that looks really great on the shelf. Well done, Uncle Larry. I thank you for this nice gift. I might even have to go get some more of these Speed Champion sets. Like, damn, they're actually a good price, too. I just really wish they'd make, you know, in the 1980s, at 28, maybe a Dodge Viper. I mean, Buick GNX, a guy can dream, right? Ah, the cookies are ready, and yep, they sure smell great, but oh boy, once they sit for a while, they don't taste good anymore. Nothing's to stop me from eating them all in one night, however. I'm gonna get some hot chocolate in the official one-of-a-kind egg mug, a collector's piece limited to one. The link to purchase it is absolutely nowhere. Now our last gift is from Brian, which means it can only be something good. Let's see.
Hi, Egg. Brian here. I am happy you reviewed the Master Grade Ball, but maybe you can get a move on with that high-grade Origin Zaku? Just a suggestion. Anyway, I found this little figure on the Kijiji, and I figured it looked like something you'd shove under your bed for multiple months until finally doing a review of it. I'll see you in 2025 when you finally review that Zeta Gundam. From Brian.
Brian, you just had to remind me, didn't you? Anyway, wow, what an amazing gift. Just what I needed. I'll crack one of these open and oh.
The gift of egg. Brian gave to me an android Chiaki.
Well, hey, that's pretty cool. This is the Nendroid Chiaki from Yuru Camp. I love this character. She has a sort of crazy energy that I really adore. And honestly, everything about Yuru Camp and his characters is just fantastic. Nendroids are neat little figures. It's not something I feel the need to get into, but I like the few that I have. This Chiaki is perfect. She looks great. Has posable twin tails, lots of nice accessories and faces. You even get this cool little winter hat with her as well. What more can you ask for? If you want to cut the card apart, then you can make a little cardboard box for her to lay in also. These figures always have a great quality to them. They look damn good on the shelf, and I'm really happy to have this little version of one of my favorite anime characters. Thank you, Brian. I'll finish the other Gundam model you sent me one of these days, and oh, what's all this other stuff? Never mind, you guys never saw anything. Well, looks like all the gifts are open, so hope you had fun with this little bit of something. I didn't finish the thing that I wanted to finish for this video, but don't worry guys, that's still coming, and that's gonna be I'm not making any promises or nothing, but oh boy, let me just put it that way. There's a lot of stuff that I'd like to review next year, so we'll see where that goes. As usual, this is just something I do for fun. I'm never gonna have a definitive upload schedule or nothing like that. I just make these videos whenever the mood strikes and the inspiration comes, you know? Well, that's really all I had to say in this video, so if you made it to the end, help yourself to one of these mediocre Christmas cookies. They've gotten awfully hard by now, but I'm sure you can get some kind of enjoyment out of them. Merry Christmas to everyone out there. Thanks for watching my videos and subscribing and stuff. That's cool. I like that. See you in the new year with some more random egg fun. But until then, bye-bye.
Stay tuned for the Yellow Knife Public Access Special, coming up next on